moving to Chicago. Not Lexi. She's my chauffeur today. Yeah, I'm going to Chicago by myself for work. Crazy. So, if you guys want to see my experience going to Chicago by myself or just traveling by myself for a couple of days, thumbs up this video and keep on watching.
Jump on the flight deck. This is your captain. Fly 1934. We're heading to Chicago. A little bit behind the schedule. We're trying to do our best up here to make up a few minutes here and there as we can. Nonetheless, we'll get you to Chicago quickly and safely as possible. Once airborne, 45 minutes in route. We sure appreciate you joining us. Sit back, relax, enjoy the flight. Welcome aboard.
So as you heard, my flight was about 30-40 minutes late, so it didn't really matter because the flight was literally probably only about 45 minutes in the air, if that. So I decided to watch an episode of The Office. Love that show. Love Steve Carell. And I barely even finished the episode because I kept making announcements. So by that time, it was already time to land, and I was in the Windy City, Chicago. Okay guys, sorry that I haven't been vlogging that much. Literally, today has been crazy. And my hair's up, I'm so hot. I literally just got to the hotel, like, maybe, I don't know what time it is. It's 4:52, so I'm on a work trip. Right. I know we have to catch up, but we will get to that a little bit later. I'm here for a couple of days, and I'm here for like an exhibition, like a show. The show is inside of a hotel, but we're not staying in that hotel. We're staying at a hotel that's about 16-minute walk. So hence you, I'm hot and sweaty and hair's up. So I had to go up and set up there, and then I walked here to check into my hotel because I had to wait because you couldn't check in until 4. So I'm exhausted. I'm gonna lay down for a little bit because me and my team are going out for dinner at 5:30. I think the reservation is at 6. I hope they don't want to be out for dinner all night because I literally don't have the strength today. So yeah, I'm gonna eat my Lexi packed me some snackies. She packed me these seaweed chips from Trader Joe's. If you never had those, amazing. And she packed me a monk pack here. So I'm gonna eat these. Thanks, Mom. We're going to Weber Grill. If you ever been to Weber Grill, they make the grills, Weber. Like, they're an actual like grill company, but apparently they have a restaurant here. I guess they're based out here. My hair looks really bad in here. Sorry, I have my watch watching. Like, I can see my camera here. So excuse me, that looks really bad. So that's about it. I'm really excited to be here. Even though I'm working, I'm excited that I get the opportunity to travel with this job. It's pretty amazing. So yeah, if you guys are still on this journey, I appreciate it. Thank you for rocking with us and me today, because this is my vlog. So yeah, I'm gonna start rambling. I'm going to stop rambling and do what I need to do. Okay, guys, I'll catch you when I'm doing something more interesting. So, I am up from my. I didn't take a nap, actually. I just kind of laid down, ate those snacks that I showed you, and I got dressed for dinner. I literally just put my hair in a ponytail with a little soup bang bang situation. And then I just put on some gloss. I brushed up my brows. I didn't put nothing on them. And I put on some blush, which is not actual blush, it's actually eyeshadow. And I put on a little bit of bronzer, just to bronze up the face. And I just put some concealer underneath my eyebrow because I nicked my eyebrow when I was dermaplaning before I left. I'm gonna meet my colleagues downstairs, which they're going to the bar, and I'm not doing that. I'm just meeting up with them so we can head to dinner together. Also, the lip gloss that I'm wearing is the Tree Hut Sheer Lips lip butter. This look is so good. Lexi got this for me for Christmas thing. I don't know where she got it from, but it's in the trash. Yeah, I don't know where she got it from, but it is so good. So if you want to get some, just search the name. Yeah. Guys, Aquafina, this is not sponsored. So I'm back at my hotel room and it's 7:35, but it was pretty decent. I got the shrimp, which I actually can show you because I didn't put it up yet. Doesn't look as nice because I put it in a container and I put it upside down. Oh no, I put it right. I walked back and it was flipped over. But it was pretty big shrimp. And it came with basmati rice and spinach. But yeah, the food was pretty decent. Yes. Do you can you hear that? That's mostly the thing that I've heard since I've been in Chicago. But yeah, so I'm going to put my food up, get out of my clothes, and put in some PJs on. I have to be up at 6:30 in the morning because I have some prep to do. And then I have to head over to the venue because it starts at 8. So that's what I'll be doing in the morning. I might talk back to you guys probably in the morning because I'll be busy all the rest of the day tomorrow. I hope you guys are enjoying this vlog. I know it hasn't been that much of an adventure quite yet just because this is the first day here. But hopefully I can get more footage of like phone stuff and like different areas. It's just weird vlogging in front of your colleagues. Like this is kind of like my personal thing, like my personal life. So that's been a little bit weird. Thanks. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna bed. Well, I'm not gonna bed, but I'm gonna chill out in the bed. And I will show you guys my room tomorrow, I think, because I hate when I forget to do a room tour before I put all my stuff out. And the room is not as beautiful as it once was before I came in here. Or I could just do it now. Should I just do it now? I don't know. Should I do it now? Before it gets worse around, because I'm about to mess up the bed because I'm about to get in it and I'm not remaking a bed for the room tour. So maybe I'll just do it now. I'll just do it now. And then I'm getting in bed. Okay, guys, I kind of straightened up a little bit. Not even that much. So really don't get your hopes up because I have to be real. This is for real. This is real life and I still have my shoes on. Okay, so this is the front door. When you come in to the right, you will see the bathroom. This is a bathroom. So here is, this is a closet. So lights up, have all the cool little hangers and things in there and then all those jazzy things. Hurry up, because I have not that much memory. Okay, so yeah, so this is the closet. And then here is like the little vanity sink section. obviously, like I said, I've already been here, have my makeup stuff, not even really makeup, because I don't even really wear makeup like that for real. And then my lip gloss and stuff like that. So there's this mirror. And then they have this crazy magnifying glass, and I look a mess. But yeah, that was handy to fix my brow. That was messed up. And then when you come in here, this is the rest of the bathroom portions. You have a obviously toilet, and then you have a stand-up shower. So this is the vibes. It's actually pretty nice. This is actually courtyard. Yeah, so that's that. So when you walk out the bathroom, then you come and turn right, and this is basically the room. So it has this cool little, it looks like a chest, but I don't even know, because I had to order some packages, so these packages met me here. So I have to take those tomorrow, but I set it down. But it's a cool, like, it looked like a little bench or something. But yeah, so once you turn right, you have the nightstand, the bed, the lamp, and then there's another lamp on the other side with the nightstand. And then that's a little couch with little footstool rest thingy. Here's the desk. Sorry, like I said, I've been here. It's my laptop and a couple iPod chargers or iPods I need to charge. So this TV curves. Oh, Shawn Mendes. Okay. Then obviously your complimentary coffee. I think this is complimentary water. I don't even know, because why does it say $7? Like, does that mean if I drink this water, you're going to charge me $7 for the day? I'm so confused. I should probably call and see. But yeah, here's the room from another angle. Very cutesy, very demure, very tiny. It's like a studio, I think. So yeah, it's pretty cute. I mean, it's just me, so I don't need that much space. My husband's coming on either Thursday night or Friday night, so he'll be here with me for one of the nights, one or two of the nights. So yeah, this is the space. Sorry I didn't do a room tour when it was fresh and super clean before I got in here. But yeah, that pretty much is it. Oh, one thing, these are so cool. They're like see-through. Like, I've never seen a nightstand like that where it's like see-through. Here, I'll go to the other one. But yeah, it's like a cool night. Well, disregard that. But a cool little nightstand with, like, you can see through it. Like, I kind of like that design. I've never seen that. It'd be quite helpful for my house. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the room tour. I will see you guys tomorrow morning once I'm getting ready for my day. I'll catch up with you guys tomorrow. Bye. You know how you wake up in a certain time and you think you have enough time to do everything you have to do? Yeah. That's what I thought this morning. That's exactly what I thought this morning. And that is not factual. It's currently 7:20. I had to be leaving at 7:15 to get to the venue and not necessarily finish setting up, but like there were some pieces that was delivered, like I showed you yesterday, that I needed to get there at a good time. But one of the managers was like, oh, we can get there at like 7:45, because he didn't think people were really going to be there at the door at 8 o'clock a.m. So he was like, we can leave here at like 7:30. They're walking. I'm not walking because I have those boxes, so I'm taking a lift to get all the stuff there. But just the, oh gosh, just the sheer fact, I woke up at 6:30, you know, did my prayer and, you know, sung the Lord a song. And, oh, it's a mirror here. Oh, this is so great. I can see my full outfit. Yeah. I did that this morning, and then I just, you know, did my brows, a little bit of blush, nothing crazy, a little concealer because something was going on down there. So yeah. And you know what's the crazy thing? I didn't bring any perfume with me because I didn't have a carry-on. I had my tiny little personal item, so I didn't know if I was gonna have to dump it or not. So I was like, let's not risk it, we could just not bring it. But yeah, let's go do a quick OOTD, and then I have to order my lift and I gotta bounce. Here you go. You guys saw me, I was ironing the tablecloth. I don't know why I didn't do that yesterday. Like, I don't know what's happening right now. I think it's just because this is my first time doing this with this company, and I don't know. I think I'm underestimating a lot of things, and then I'm overestimating things. So it's just like, Brit, chill. Okay, anyway, OOTD. Oh, why does my camera look so dirty? Hold on. Pulse. Are you clean now? I don't even know. Sorry, the lighting's really bad. But this is the outfit that I'm wearing today. I think I'm just gonna wear my hair down. I'm not too sure. Yesterday I wore it, saw it in a cute ponytail, but I don't know about today. But yes, here's the outfit. I'm wearing this blazer. I think everything is thrifted besides this. What is it called? What is this called when it connects like a diaper? Whatever, you know what it is. But I'm wearing that. That's from Target. But this is all thrifted. And I'm wearing, these are the Crocs, like dressy shoe. Because I'm gonna be standing most of the day, I think. I don't even know, obviously, but yeah. This is the outfit. Jewelry is my Pandora bracelet. I'm gonna put my Apple Watch on. Necklace is Swarovski. I don't know where these earrings are from. My mom got me these earrings, or gave me these earrings. Yeah, so that's it. I'll probably check in with you guys a little later. I'm not too sure. We'll see how today goes, but yeah, that's the outfit. Different. I'd never, like, if you asked me if I would wear something like this 2 years ago, I'd say girl, bye. But yeah, here we go. Okay guys, first day down. It was a crazy day, but pretty fun actually. But before I go over what we did today, because I didn't get that much footage today. I mean, I kind of did, but that was more so for work purposes. So we went to the exhibition. I was there for about 11 hours or so. And then me and my colleagues, I think I told you this earlier, went out to dinner together. We went to La Briola Cafe, I think. La Briola Chicago. Which was really loud in there, and our appointment was at like 7:45, and it was so crowded. I'm like, I guess Chicago is very touristy, and people are just out in the streets on a Thursday night. Yeah, so the dinner went good. This is my first time actually like being around everybody and like outside of work. So for me, I think I am extroverted introvert, maybe that's what it is. So I don't like small talk, and so going into these situations, I was just like, oh my God, small talk. Like I literally, like I can do it. I just don't like, it gets internal cringe. But it ended up being fine. I got to know a lot of them better, like in more of a personal level. And they were giving me my accolades. Like they said I was amazing and I'm so helpful and they're so grateful for me being a part of the team and all those good words. So that was very reassuring. So yeah, I had a good day. But let me get into the testimony portion. Like last time I talked to you guys, I didn't have a job. A lot has happened since then. So, as you guys know, I had lost my job in April, actually, April 1st, because it was April Fool's Day. And I got the call that my services were no longer needed, and that it was a let go situation because it was due to lack of work, apparently. I don't know the full details, but that's what they said. Obviously, when you get a call like that, that was very detrimental to me. I was very much so in shock. I was just coming up on my 2 years of being at that company. And then you get a call like that, it's just like, huh. Sorry, I'm trying not to be that long, so I keep looking at my watch because I have my video on again. If you don't do this on your Apple Watch, it's a hack. Yeah, so I had been at that company for 2 years, and me and my husband, we were just about to move in May, like a month after. We was going to move May 1st, so I got the call that I had lost my job a month before we were about to move, and I was just like, what great timing. I mean, obviously God knew, but it was a struggle, and this past summer has been, it was a struggle for sure, not only like financially, but just trying to figure out where God wanted me to be and trying to pick up the pieces essentially. Yeah, it was just a lot of things just going on this summer, and yeah, I was like working on my business because I know I still want to do that. And so I spent the summer just trying to figure that out, doing the groundwork, figuring out concepts and avenues and stuff that I want to do. Yeah, and just trying to get closer to God, you know, because God had given me this time to, he had my undivided attention. When I lost my job, like I literally had, nothing was filling my time unless I like forced it upon. So I spent most of my time reading the Bible and just spending intentional time with God. And so 4 months had went past, and oh, it was a 4 months, just about 4 months, and I had got a call that, well, first of all, actually, rewind. This particular job that I am at currently, I had applied for in May, and there was, you know, some situations going on with that company that they ended up couldn't hire anybody at that time. So, what is that? 2 months later, they ended up following up with me saying that they, you know, wanted me to interview for them. And it was a long process for the interviewing portion. I think it was like three interviews or so. But then, yeah, I had got a job and I'm making a lot more money than I was making at my previous job, just full transparency. And it is a completely different industry that I have been in thus far in my career. But I think that God has just put me in different arenas and industries so far. Like each job that I've had coming out of college has been a different industry, and so this is not different. So I've always entered into an industry that I've never been in before. So I feel like God is just putting me in a different space for whatever reason. I'm not really too sure yet. But I know this job has been a blessing for me and my family. So yeah, that's the testimony minus a couple other details. But yeah, I am fully employed. I have like this, not list, but like things I was believing God for in my next career move, in my next job, and he definitely checked off the list for sure. So I'm just grateful that God entrusted me to be a steward over this position and role. So I'm excited to see what else he has in store for me. So yeah, that's why I had always wanted to be to have the opportunity to travel with the company, and this company has allowed me to travel. I won't be traveling that much, but this is the first time I've definitely traveled with a company, and it's been a great experience thus far. So I'm just really grateful for that. So yeah, that's why I'm in Chicago, and I have a job now, so this is great. So I'm sorry, it's just been really busy, that's why I haven't really vlogged since being here. But tomorrow's my last day working. Tomorrow's Friday, and I think I'm gonna ditch the crew a little bit early because my husband's coming in the morning, actually, like 7 a.m. So, and it's currently 10:06. Actually, no, he's gonna come here 8 a.m. this time. So yeah, so he'll be here, and then I'm meeting my friend for the first time in Chicago. I'm gonna see if I'm gonna vlog or not. I don't know if she's comfortable with me doing that. I might ask. So I'll actually be getting to like explore more of Chicago. Yeah, so I'm going to take off this jewelry, wipe my face with the fake makeup I had on today, and get in the bed. I might turn the TV on, but it's only like 50 channels really, so it's probably nothing really on. And then I'm gonna go to bed. So I just want to check in with you guys. I'm gonna go to the exhibition a little bit later tomorrow. I have to work on a couple of social media posts. Oh yeah, and I'm still doing marketing. I think I've mentioned that before on this channel, but yeah, I'm still doing marketing, so that's what I'm doing for this company. Yeah, okay, I'm rambling too much. I'm tired. Okay, all right guys, I will check in with you in the next clip for you, but in the morning for me. Bye.
There's a bakery, it's called Love Bakery. I gotta take you there. It's fantastic. They open at 6 a.m. Those are like 6, 7, or 5, 6, 2 o'clock.
Okay guys, so we've been walking around Chicago. Got Gary's popcorn. Amazing. So sorry I haven't been filming. But we are eating, what is this called?
Star Donuts.
Star Donuts. So he's gonna try, this is the new color one. Yeah, no, you can try first. Have you had Nutella before?
No.
Oh my God.
What's your thoughts?
Pretty good. I wish it was a little bit more, moist. Yeah. But we didn't get to the Nutella part.
Yeah. What?
We didn't get to the Nutella part yet.
No. Plenty of it.
Okay. Would you rate it?
3.5 out of 5.
Same.
Okay, guys. Sorry, lighting's terrible. 1 second. Actually, it's still pretty bad. But I just made it back from Chicago. It's 10. My watch is dead. It's 10:36. And I have received my package from Shein that was delivered while I was gone. So I wanted to open it up with you guys. I just cracked it open, but I didn't look in it yet. So we can look at what I got. So, I got a bonnet for my daughter, which I don't really talk about that much on the channel, but she just turned 10. And I got a bonnet for her hair, because I have had some bonnets, but they were too big for her head. So hopefully this one will fit her head. And then I got phone cases. Like, I love, if you ever like see my phones or like in person or in some of the videos, honestly, I typically get my phone cases from Shein or Five Below. Yeah, those are like my top places that I get my phone cases from. So this one is a Jesus case. Oh, it's cute. It's cute. Can you guys see that? It's a cute, nice, soft. It's thick. It's like a high-rise case almost. Yeah, it's really cute. I like it. And I like the colors. Very fall colors. That's that one. I also got her my daughter a little small little jewelry box pouch, because she's into jewelry these days. But I wasn't gonna buy a full blown jewelry box because she don't need that. She doesn't have that much jewelry. I mean, we're gonna get her more, but just something cute to start off with. Oh, it's cute. You have to put the dividers on there. It's cute, like, little spots for, I mean, it's not the most expensive thing, but it'll do. Like, you put, like, your little earrings in there, then it has these, like, little dividers you can put in there, and then it has this pouch in the front. So, it's cute. It's good enough for a 10-year-old. So we have that, and like if we go travel somewhere or she's going to somebody else's house, she could just take this. It's very functional. I'm all about functionality. And I got another phone case. Ooh, I like this one. Jesus loves you. Sorry, rudely interrupted. My phone decided to turn off. But yeah. I forgot about these clear cases that my phone is cracked, so you can see that. But that could be a message, like broken and cracked, but Jesus still loves you. Yeah. Yeah. Most of this, the purchases for this order was for her birthday, and she wanted bell bottoms. Apparently kids are into these bell bottoms these days. So, these are actually not bad quality. Hope these aren't too long for her. They are, there's like a knitted, can't really tell, but they're a knitted pants leg with the bell bottoms on it. So that's what they look like. I think she could fit these. These might be kind of long though, but hopefully she'll grow into them and hopefully she still likes them at that point. But, because I feel like they're going to grow sports every 5 seconds, so she should be good. But these are pretty good quality. I'm surprised. And then I got me a pink spray bottle. It's gonna be for my hair and her hair. Obviously not now because it's in braids, but when I wear my hair curly or like in between washes or to tangle, I got one of the misters. So I used to have a black one, but I don't know what happened to it. So this should get the job done. So yeah, that was all I got from Shein. Yeah, thanks for watching my haul. But it's late now and I'm about to get to bed, so I'll probably catch up with you guys tomorrow just to go over a recap and stuff. Yeah, that's about it. So I will see you guys in the next clip. Good night.